Hi beauties, welcome back to my channel. So I wanted to share this makeup look with you girls today. It is a beautiful shimmery silvery look that would be perfect for the holidays or party, maybe a New Year's party, something like that. And I love this time of year because I just feel like I just want to put glitter on my face. I want to put glitter on my eyes and shimmer everywhere. I feel like this time of year just calls for that sort of thing. So I love the way this came out and I can't wait to share it with you. I also wanted to share with you before we jump in, I know a lot of you will probably comment that my hair looks a little darker. I did tone down my highlights. So I wanted to share with you what I used. I did not do my roots. I need to do my roots because you can see like my natural color starting to come in a little bit. So I did order a new hair color that I'm going to color my roots with, but it hasn't arrived and I really needed to tone down the highlights in my hair. So I wanted to share with you what I used. This is the color by Paul Mitchell and this is what I use a lot to tone down my hair. And this time I got the color 7NB, which is neutral blonde, and neutral blonde is pretty much like the lightest brown you can get. At least that's what it looks like to me. And I picked something in the neutral family, that way it would tone down the brassiness in my hair. So I wanted to share that with you, and I use, there's two different types of developer if you can get your hands on the color by Paul Mitchell, and I always use the clear, which is the more liquidy one, and the reason why I use that is because I feel like it adds more shine to your hair than the creamier one. All right, so let's go ahead and jump into this makeup look. So I already have my eyebrow done, and now I'm gonna go ahead and take some concealer and just touch up all of the edges and then prime my eyelid with that same concealer. And this is the MAC Pro Longwear in NC25. Now I'm gonna highlight my brow with Blanc Type by MAC, and I'm actually gonna pack on a lot and then blend it out. It just really works well to blend out shadows this way. It gives you like a more flawless finish. For my crease color, I'm going into light brown out of the Lorac Pro 2 palette. So at first, I'm gonna just blend this right above my crease and into that brow highlight. Then I'm gonna pick up a little bit more color and really get into my crease. Still with the light brown. Taking a piece of tape and I'm gonna stick this to a paper towel and just so it's not so sticky. And I'm gonna put this on the outer edge of my eye for a guide. I'm not going up to my lash line with this, like my lower lash line. And this is the guide to our wing liner, so that's why I'm double checking to make sure they're even. Now going into Snow out of the Lorac Pro 2 palette. And with this, I'm gonna highlight my inner corner. Here I'm taking some Fix Plus and I'm going to go into Space Cowboy by Urban Decay. Now I'm going to just tap this all over the lid and into that inner corner. I'm going to get a base of this on with the Fix Plus and then I'm going to actually use my finger to kind of rub it in because it works really well when you do it like that. And then I'm gonna take the brush that we went into light brown with and I'm just gonna blend out those edges. Now for liner, I'm using Schwing by The Balm. And then then I'm gonna take a black liner just to tight line underneath my lashes. This is Mally pencil liner in Midnight. On my waterline and lash line, I'm adding a white metallic eyeliner, and this is Yayo by Urban Decay. It's not really my favorite product, but. And now for the silver, I'm using Platinum Pigment by MAC, and I'm also using Fix Plus with this. After you get a good like base of that, you can go in and blend out the edges. I'm using that same brush that I used for light brown in our crease. And then once you do your foundation and concealer, it will all be nice and polished. And at this point, it does look a little weird until you get your mascara and lashes on. Now I'm taking a silver glitter eyeliner by NYX. And I'm just gonna tap this underneath my lashes. Do not get this too close to your eye because it will make your eye water. Or at least it did mine. I don't know what it is about that NYX glitter liner, but it like makes my skin burn. So I'm not sure I can recommend that. If you can find something else, definitely use something else. And just for my bottom lashes, I'm using the Maybelline Big Eyes Mascara, the one that goes on the bottom lashes. And I absolutely love this wand. It's perfect. It's so small. You can like get in there and like really pack on a lot of mascara to your bottom lashes. And for my top lashes, I'm adding the L'Oreal Voluminous Butterfly Mascara, which is my new favorite mascara. Thank you, Wendy from Bentley Blonde. I heard about this on her channel and I'm like so thankful. Now I'm gonna pop on my lashes. And these are the Ardell Wispy Lashes, of course. Add some mascara to blend these in. So if you guys have used this L'Oreal Voluminous Butterfly, leave your comments down below of what you thought of it, because I'm completely impressed with it. So I would love to hear what you girls think of it. I feel like I'm never ever gonna buy another expensive mascara again, because I feel like there are so many great options in the drugstore. So I mean, like things like foundation and things, I'll always probably splurge a little bit, but like mascara, it's just too similar and there's too many great options. Okay, so eyes are done and now I'm gonna work on the rest of my face. I did have a little bit of old foundation on from earlier in the day, but I'm gonna touch it up. Underneath my foundation, I tried out this for the very first time. It's called Boost It, and I put it kind of like where I would put my concealer, and it just says it instantly tightens and brightens the appearance of your skin. So it does have like a sheen to it, and you can feel it kind of tightening up, but I'm not really sure how I feel about it. I got this like months ago in a new beauty test tube, so I wanted to try it out. So the foundation that I had on already is the NARS Sheer Glow, so I'm just gonna touch this up a little bit. I'm taking the Maybelline Fit Me foundation stick. I'm just gonna add this into like the contour of my cheekbones, and I'll put some on my forehead too. My jawline. So I'm gonna blend this out because I'm gonna do a little bit more contouring. I'm just gonna blend this in with my same foundation brush. And just to set this a little, I'm going in with a very light contour. This is the Chocolate Soleil and Milk Chocolate by Too Faced. Oh my gosh, I forgot concealer. Seriously? I cannot believe I forgot my concealer. So my concealer is the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer. My color is Sand Sable. I'm gonna try to make this happen even though I have setting powder on already, but I'm just gonna like lightly do it because I need it. Okay, so I'm not gonna use quite as much as I normally would, because I just don't, I don't want it to get all too cakey, because I did my setting powder already. All right, it actually doesn't look too bad at all, so. Okay, I'm so glad that was not a disaster. For cheeks, I'm going on with Mocha by MAC. And for my highlight, I'm using Soft and Gentle. I'm also gonna take a little bit of this and put it right above my lip right here. For my lips, I'm starting out with Too Faced's Perfect Nude. And then Stripped Down by MAC. But it always goes when you need it the most. The kindest love is still bleeding from the last shot. And on top of that, I'm using Blush Gloss by Jouer. Cause it's not good. And then right in the center of my bottom lip, I'm using Jouer's gloss in Glisten. But it always goes,